it always struggled against white domination. Always struggled against white domination. Never struggled against the white man. Not the ANC. And that is what attracted a white man to the ANC. Because he knew that he was not a target. What he tested together with all of us was white domination. The second point I want to make is that we have heard the story of the ANC today is not the same as that one. And I always give people one answer, I think it's standard time. If the ANC was the same, in 1970, 1980, 1990, 2009, it would be a dead one.
Oh, that's true.
The reason it looks different is because it is a living organization. It worked under condition of illegality. It was tight, very strict, screening people. It is an open organization for everybody. And what we should be looking at, that's why Chavez is actually saying, how do you correct some of the weaknesses is the challenge, because when you open fresh air, that's what the Chinese say, mosquitoes also come. You don't deprive yourself of fresh air because there are mosquitoes. You deal with the mosquitoes, but you still access fresh air. That is the challenge facing the ANC today. We're very alive to that, that the big organization now is open to everybody. Others join the ANC with bad intentions. And they find themselves here. But you can't say, therefore, what do you do? We have a challenge and a responsibility to deal with those dynamics. And I can tell you that I'm as proud of the ANC now as I was ever. Did we let the people of the Western Cape down after 1994? I think that is the reason for that. Very good. We also think that the people of the Western Cape let them down after that. And the people of the Western always think that the ANC let them down. It means that something is new and common. And I always explain this that we never won the Western Cape. That is the only province in the country that the ANC has never won. In 1994, there were three. Today is one. And I think it was Northern Cape, it was a hung parliament. We had to appeal to a DP sole MP to take any decision in Cape. We have a majority now, we're running to Northern Cape. It was KZN. We're running KZN now. The only outpost that we must work at is the West Cape. That is reality, and don't deny it. Accept it and say, what more can we do? I want to tell you what pressure we put our Maria's family. Because we want them to change the situation instantly, and sometimes it's very difficult. But let me make one last point on the thing, then I will come to the benefits. The last part of education is that education doesn't work if family structure collapses. Not the school structure, family structure. Start here from me.
What I think is beginning to crack is the family structure as a unit, as the smallest unit of society. Under these conditions, I have four kids. Two of them are graduates under this system. And I know that one time my youngest daughter in a school led a walkout by students. And I was summoned to school.
It said, like father, like daughter.
No. And I was summoned to that school to explain. How is this thing treated of this time, which means all that I did, the walkout of the school. Then I had to think very carefully. When I arrived there, I gave a simple answer. I said, listen, Mrs. Graham, who was the principal, said, you see, At home, I instill discipline. At school, it's your responsibility. But I want to give you only one assurance and I leave. If you discipline my child in school, I won't come and confront you.
Whoa.
I won't come and confront you. It's your responsibility. And I left him there, and I left it there, and we are doing an agreement. So I'm saying, yes, education system, respect and all that bad, but there is a complementarity between what happens at school and what happens at home.
And just stop for 1 second, Esther, just to reinforce that point. A study was done by the HSRC recently on school performance. And you know, some of our most under-resourced schools, you're getting very good performance by some kids. And they said, what makes the difference? And the big, what you're saying is absolutely right. Their research shows the biggest difference is what happens in the family.
So, I'm not in denial. I know that there are many problems in education.
I accept that.
But I also accept that one of the biggest problems is the collapse almost of the family unit. And that makes a big difference in any development of a child. But let's have a long debate on that the other day. And I'm always boasting about this child, that I have succeeded to produce two girls, right? The third one in making now. What one? The last one, I don't know, is a bit slipper. But it's fine.
And the two has the intelligence of the mother.
All of them. All of them. The intelligence from the mother. The other bad aspect of the father. So that is the one I think we must have a discussion on. Family structure. It's a big, big thing in South Africa. The last point is, can we address all these issues? ANC has no magic. ANC has no magic. The ANC can address every problem within the community structure. Therefore, your ideas are as important as everybody's ideas. Bring that to the fore. Suggest, tell us what we want to do. Let's have a discussion. Let's work together. Then we can find a solution to many things. Mm-hmm. But if we wait for the ANC to bring the solutions, we're all going to be disappointed. All of us. Because it will not have the magic. People who know the structure in a community are members of that community. Only when you tap into that wisdom can you resolve problems.
Thank you.